Hello everyone, today we are going to start with the reactions of alcohols, the third category of reactions. The first two reactions which we have already discussed were, the first one was the reactions which involved the cleavage of oxygen-hydrogen bond, and the second one was the reactions which involved the cleavage of carbon-oxygen bond. And let us just recapitulate what reactions did we see here. In the first case, we saw the first reactions which were talking about the acidity of alcohols. And the second reaction which we saw was esterification of alcohols. In the second category of reactions, where we had CO bond cleavage, we had seen three types of important reactions. The first reaction was Lucas test. The second reaction was halogenation using the reagents like SOCl2, PCl3, PCl5. And the last reaction which we saw, where we had discussed the mechanism also, was dehydration of alcohols at 443 Kelvin. So these were basically the reactions which we have covered so far. And today let us start with the last category of reactions, that is general reactions of alcohols. The reaction which we will be talking about is oxidation first. Now what is oxidation? We all know is addition of oxygen, or it can sometimes be also called as removal of electropositive metals, elements like hydrogen. So any of the two definitions you will find in the case of oxidation of alcohols. Now we have two types of oxidizing agents depending upon what reaction do we want to carry out. If you want to carry out only one step reaction or partial oxidation, then you will use mild oxidizing agents. And if you want to carry out complete oxidation, then it will be a two step reaction and the reagents will be very, very strong. Let's see the reagents. The first reagent which is very light and mild is PCC. It is called as pyridinium chlorochromate. The second reagent is chromic anhydride, CrO3. The strong oxidizing agents are potassium permanganate with concentrated H2SO4. So it is called acidified potassium permanganate. And this is acidified potassium dichromate or concentrated HNO3. Now let me show you how to use these reagents and when to use these reagents. The first reagent which I'm going to use is PCC. So for that, let us take a primary alcohol. Now when you oxidize an alcohol, in the first step you have to remove the hydroxyl hydrogen atom and an alpha hydrogen atom. So when you do so, you will get CH3C. One of the hydrogens is still there, H, and double bond O. So this is your first condition. You have used a mild reagent PCC, suppose. So the reaction will stop here. But if you continue this reaction with a strong oxidizing agent like potassium permanganate and H2SO4, the reaction will go to the second stage also. So in the first step, you will get aldehyde, but the reaction will continue further because it is a very strong oxidizing agent, and now it will get further oxidized. So aldehydes, when they get oxidized, you will get acids. What you have to do is just you have to add one oxygen atom with the hydrogen. So it is a very easy process, just adding an oxygen. So oxidation of aldehydes to carboxylic acid will take place, and it is a very easy step. So what we learned here is the primary alcohols on oxidation will give you aldehydes. Aldehydes on further oxidation will give you acids. Let us take a secondary alcohol. I have taken a secondary alcohol, propanol, propane-2-ol, and for oxidation with a PCC, that is mild oxidizing agent, first you have to remove the hydroxyl H and the alpha H. So there is one alpha H here. Remove both the hydrogens, what you get is a ketone, CH3C CH3, and the oxygen will have a double bond here, so ketone is obtained. So secondary alcohols on oxidation will give you ketones, and ketones can further get oxidized if you use a very strong oxidizing agent. So what if I use potassium permanganate here in the first step? So definitely first I'll get this. And in the second step, it will further get oxidized to give you two acids, because here I cannot insert oxygen atom anywhere like that, because I don't have a CH bond. So you have to break one of the carbon-carbon bonds and you will get two fragments. CH3C double bond O is the first fragment which you can see, and you have to attach OH and make it an acid, and the second fragment which contains one carbon atom will automatically become an acid with one carbon atom. So the methyl group becomes formic acid. So this is how we are going to get two acids by oxidation of ketones. In the second example, we have taken again a secondary alcohol here, which is pentane 2-ol, and we will oxidize it with PCC first. And what we do is remove the OH hydrogen and the alpha hydrogen atom. So get a ketone, CH3CH2, CH2C, double bond OCH3. This was if you use a mild oxidizing agent. But if you use a strong oxidizing agent like potassium permanganate, acidified, you will first get this product and then it will again get oxidized further to give you acids. Now how to form acids? You have to break one of the bonds. You can break CC bond, this CC bond that is A, or let us say this CC bond that is B. We have to use an important rule here, Popov's rule, according to which whenever you break the CC bond in ketones during oxidation, the carbonyl group remains attached with the smaller alkyl group. So you have to bear this in mind, that the small alkyl group remains attached with the carbonyl. So small alkyl group plus C double bond, you will keep them together. This is the rule. So here we have two alkyl groups, the methyl group is there and a big propyl group is there. So you're going to keep the methyl group with the CO. When you keep it with CO, the bond A will break. So the major product is when the bond A breaks. So we have two steps here. The first, when the bond A breaks, I will get CH3CH2CH2 as one of the fragments, and the second fragment will be CH3C double bond O and a dash, because I have broken this bond. Now from wherever you broke the bond, you have to attach some groups in such a way that you get an acid. So you get OH plus. Now here what we will attach, naturally we'll convert this into double bond OH. So this will be the second acid. Propanoic acid and ethanoic acid are the major products formed. And if you did the bond B, that is the minor products, you will get the first acid as methanoic acid and the second acid as 4-butanoic acid. So butanoic acid plus methanoic acid will be your minor products. In exam, you will be writing the major products as the answer. Let us oxidize tertiary butyl alcohol with KMnO4. Now, KMnO4 is a very strong oxidizing agent, but the condition here is difficult because we don't have an alpha hydrogen atom. So this condition is preventing the oxidation of tertiary alcohols. This question is important for your board exam. Why are tertiary alcohols resistant towards oxidation? Because they do not have alpha hydrogen atom. So we'll just put a cross over here that the reaction does not take place. But under very vigorous conditions, if we carry out this reaction with concentrated HNO3 or even with KMnO4 at very, very high temperatures, then the reaction can take place. And in that case, you will remove the beta hydrogen atom. Since you don't have alpha, you will remove the beta. So look at this alpha, this is beta. So you have beta carbon, beta hydrogens, 3 plus 3 plus 3, 9 beta hydrogens. One of the beta hydrogens you have to knock out. So I'll show you how to do that. So I have just removed the beta hydrogen atom in open fashion. Now you just remove this. Look at that. So it's going out as H plus, and this is going out as OH minus. So the product formed is actually, after dehydration, an alkene. So you will get this compound, 2-methylpropene plus H2O. So in the first step, alkene is formed and you're continuing with the oxidation. So the bond breaks, the double bond breaks, like how you break it in ozonolysis. So you will get CCH3CH3, and wherever the double bond was there, you will just write oxygen. And same way here, wherever the double bond was there, you will write oxygen. Look at that. So what you get is two carbonyl compounds, which can be any compound. In the present case, it is a ketone and this is an aldehyde. And we all know that ketones can also get oxidized further and aldehydes can also get oxidized further. So let's oxidize them. So the reaction continues. And one of the C-C bonds you have to break now in ketones by using Popov's rule. Now in Popov's rule, the smaller alkyl group remains with the carbonyl carbon. In this case, both of them are same. So we can just break any bond, either this bond or this bond. So let's break this. So we'll get one carbon containing acid, that is formic acid, and two carbon containing acid, that is ethanoic acid. And this is an aldehyde. We can write it in a nice way like this, HC double bond OH. And when we oxidize this, oxygen will get incorporated in the molecule and we'll get HCOOH. So finally, we can say that the tertiary alcohols are very difficult to oxidize because they do not have alpha hydrogen atom. But under very vigorous conditions, they can get oxidized to yield a mixture of acids. Here we are getting three acids.